Hello everyone, this is Christian, and lately I've noticed that while our analytics tools are by far the most powerful we currently offer, they are also the least well understood. Not because they are complex, but rather because people are not used to this kind of tool. So today, we'll take a few minutes and I will show you the basic principle behind our analytics section. Let's start by selecting interesting objects. The first one will be the room temperature. And here I'm validating that there's plenty of data. Yes. I add it to the briefcase here, which is just another way of saying that I intend to study it further. Now I also want the air supply temperature and the fan operation. This one. So you could make simple charts, but today we are interested into the analytics section. So what are we seeing here? The first thing to notice is that those are, contrary to most dashboards or graphical tools or whatnot, those are not static images. They are fully interactive filtering tools. And this is very powerful. Let me show you. So here we have around 6 months of data. But say I'm only interested in what happened on November. I can select November. In addition, I'm only interested in what happened on the weekends. So I can select Sunday and Saturday. And now, the only remaining data is the one that occurred on November on the weekends. Every chart is a filtering tool. Every time I'm selecting something, every other chart is updated accordingly. And not only the charts, the spreadsheet at the bottom of the page is also updated. So I can easily filter interesting info and then export it to Excel if I so desire. Anyhow, let's start fresh. Let's say that we just stumble upon this system. We want to understand how it works. So the first object here is the room temperature, this is the air supply, and this is the fan operation. So the room temperature. This is the temperature profile, a normal curve centered around 19 to 20 degrees, which for a physical education room is understandable. Now, the air supply. This is a little trickier. Why is there two normal curves? Usually, you would expect to have just one, like this one. But there's two. So to understand what's happening, we will check for the lowest temperature curve. Oh, look. It's when the fan is not working. So we recorded data probably at night, when the fan was not working and there was some cold air infiltration. So not only is it worthless data, it's worse than worthless data. This is polluting our sampling. And let me explain why. We want to study how the system reacts when we are in control, when the fan is working, when the coils are working, adjusting in function of the temperature. So this data here is not when the system is working. We need to get rid of it. To do so, we can select on here. So we will keep only the data when the fan is working. And as one would expect, here you have a normal curve centered around 19 degrees. We can also see that this fan here is working only at daytime, between 6:30 a.m. to around 9:30 p.m. and almost always on the weekdays. So you can conclude that there is a schedule for this fan. Not only that, you can validate the schedule. You can see that it never worked at night for the entire 6 months of the data we have. So this is it. This is the basic principle of our analytics tools. A chart is a filter in itself.